A very good afternoon to all my dear students. We have completed our first chapter of morphology of flower in semester 5 paper 2 unit 2 angiosperms 1. The next chapter of the unit 2 of angiosperm 1 is complete classification of Bentham and Hooker. I am Dr. Rajendra Shevde, HOD, Department of Botany, Arts, Commerce and Science College, Lanja, Ratnagiri. Welcome you all to this presentation of complete classification of Bentham and Hooker. Let's start with it. These are the two scientists, George Bentham, 1800 to 1884. He was a self-called botanist, and Sir Joseph Dalton Hooker, 1817 to 1911, he was the first director of the Royal Botanical Garden, Kew, London. Both of them have developed this classification system, and keep in mind that it is one of the most widely universally accepted classification system for angiospermic plants. So Bentham and Hooker system of classification, the system of classification of seed plants was proposed by Bentham and Hooker. So they have proposed the classification of plants which do possesses the seeds. It's the most well developed natural classification system. It was published in three volumes work, Genera Plantarum, in 1862 to 1883. They describe about 97,205 species of seed plants belonging to 7,569 genera of 202 families, starting from Ranunculaceae up to Gramineae. So it's a huge work they did in 1862 to 1883, and they published three volumes, and the three volumes of Genera Plantarum. About 97,205 species they classified and described, belonging to 7,569 genera and 202 families. So the Ranunculaceae has been considered as the most primitive families, whereas the Gramineae has been considered to be the most advanced family. The delimitation of genera was based on natural affinities and was pre-Darwinian in concept. The system divided all the seed plants into three classes. Means Bentham and Hooker has classification system which is divided into three classes. One, dicotyledons, which consist of 165 families. Two, gymnosperms, consist of three families, and monocotyledons consist of 34 families. This dicotyledony, with 165 families, has been again divided into three subclasses: polypetaly, gamopetaly, and monochlamydy. So, what is exactly the Bentham and Hooker system? This pictures depicts you the overall classification system. Here we can see that plant kingdom, they have classified plant kingdom into cryptogams and phanerogams, where cryptogams are considered to be non-flowering plants, whereas the phanerogams, which are nothing but the flowering plants. So again, that phanerogams or the flowering plants are divided into three classes: the dicotyledons, then gymnospermy, and then monocotyledony. So again, dicotyledon are divided into three subclasses: polypetaly, gamopetaly, and monochlamydy. The monocotyledony are divided into various series. Polypetaly divided into three series, gamopetaly into three series, monochlamydy into seven series. Whereas monocotyledon are divided into seven family series again. So this is the overall picture of the Bentham Hanukkah system of classification. So let's start with what they did, how they have classified the seed bearing plants. So starting with the subclass 1, Polypetali. Polypetali, sepals and petals are distinct, petals are free. So they divided it into 14 series, 25 orders and 165 families. Again, that series, subclasses are divided into Thalamiflora, flowers hypogynous, stamens many and disc absent. Six orders, runnels, parietals, polygoniani, caryophyllini, gutiferals and malvels. So Thalamiflora is again divided into six orders. Next is Disciflora. Here the characters considered are flower or hypogynous, disc present but below the ovary. So again there are four orders: geraniels, holocales, selaterals, sapindals. So these are the four orders divided. Then Calyciflora, flowers are perigynous or epigynous. They divide it into five orders: rosales, myrtales, passiflorales, ficoidales and umbelles. So total 15 series are there, orders are there. Then again subclass Gamepetali. Here Gamepetali means sepals and petals both are distinct but petals are fused. Inferi. Ovary is inferior, that's why this order is inferi. So there are three orders: rubials, asterals and campanelles. The next, that is heteromery. Ovary superior, stamens in one or two whorls, carpels more than two. Here are three orders: ericals, primulales and ibinals. And the third one, bicarpality. Ovary superior, stamens in two worth, but carpels are two. There are four orders: Jentianales, Polymoniales, Personales and Lamiales. So this is about the Gamepetali. Now let's come to the subclass 3, that is Monochlamydiae. Monochlamydiae, flowers are opetalous, perianth lacking or if present not differentiated into sepals and petals. So there are seven different orders: curve embry, embryo coiled, ovule usually one, multi-ovulate, aquati, aquatic plants, ovules many, multi-ovulate, terrestris, terrestrial plants, ovules many, microembryo, embryo minute, diaphanelles, diaphanelles, carpels one, ovule one, achlamydospory, ovary inferior, unilocular, ovules 1 to 3, unisexual, flowers unisexual. Ordens anomaly, relationship is uncertain. So let's see next class, that is Gymnospermie. Bentham Hanukkah has considered Gymnospermie between the first class Dicotyledon and the third class Monocotyledon. So let's see what is the second class Gymnospermie. It here the ovules are naked. Considering dicot and monocot, ovules are not naked. So they divided this into three families. class 3 monocotyledons. Flowers, trimerous. Venation, parallel. Again, they are divided into various orders. Microsperme, ovary, inferior. Seeds, minute. Epigyne, ovary, inferior. Seeds, large. Coronary, ovary, superior. Carpels, united. Perianth, colored. Callosini, ovary, superior. Carpels, united. Perianth is green. Nudiflori, ovary, superior, but perianth is absent. Apocarpi, ovary, superior. Carpels, more than one, and they are free. So that's why the name of this order is Apocarpi. Glumaceae, ovary, superior. Perianth is not absent but reduced. Flowers are enclosed in glumes. So they are named after this characters as Glumaceae. So after going through the details of the Bentham and Hooker system of classification, one must know what are the merits and demerits of Bentham and Hooker system of classification. The first one is that each plant has been described either from the actual specimen or preserved herbarium sheets, so that the descriptions are detailed as well as quite accurate. Keep in mind that they both Bentham and Hooker, they have collected actual specimens, and if the actual specimen is not available, they have studied the preserved herbarium sheet. So whatever the description has been given for each plant or each species is actually very, very accurate. The system is highly practical and is useful to students of systematic botany for easy identification of species, as the accuracy is very high. So it's very practical to study the plant, and for systematic botany students, it is very useful for identifying the species. The flora describes geographical distribution of species and genera. They have not only classified the plants or the species, but they have described the geographical distribution, and their description includes for both genera and the species also. The genetic description are complete, accurate, and based on their direct observation. Whatever the generic description they have given, they are total, complete. They are very accurate, and also they are based on the direct observation. It is not depending upon the information collected. It has been mentioned with the direct observation, not from the information collected. So let's see what are the other merits. Larger genera have been divided into subgenera, each with specific number of species. So this is one of the perfect merits of this Bentham Hooker, that larger genera are divided into two subgenera, and they are dividing larger genera into two genera, then they are dividing the specific number of species also. Dicot being with the order Ranales, which are now universally considered as to be most primitive angiosperm. So I have mentioned you about the Ranunculaceae in the earlier slide. So dicots, they consider Ranales being most primitive angiosperm. Placing of monocots after the dicot is again a natural one, and according to evolutionary trend. If you consider if you go through the observation, the dicot shows the primitive characters, whereas the monocot shows the morphological characters which are very advanced. So they are placing monocots after the dicots, that's why it is shows that evolutionary trend. Placing of series DC flori in between thalami flori and callosi flori is quite natural. So what they have done, thalami flori has been considered as a primitive, whereas the callosi flori has been considered as an advanced one. So they place TDC flory in between thalamic flory and calyce flory. So it shows the natural characteristics of evolutionary trends. Placing of gamma petali after polypetali is justified since unions of petali is considered to be an advanced feature over the free condition. Now gamma petalis and polypetalis. So gamma petali has been considered first one, whereas the polypetali is considered as the free. So polypetali is the primitive character. So they place the gamma petali after the polypetali. This is considered because the gamma petalis characteristics is considered as the advanced one. So this is also merit of the Bentham Hanukkah system. Now let's see what are the demerits of Bentham Hanukkah systems of classification. Keeping gymnosperm in between dicots and monocots is anomalous. Now, gymnosperms are, of course, they are seed-bearing plants, and gymnosperms are also seed-bearing plants. But both dicots and monocots, both are having seeds which are enclosed. So, in between the monocots and dicots, gymnos cannot be placed. So, this is what the anomaly is found by keeping gymnosperm between dicots and monocots. Subclass Monochlamydiae is quite artificial. Now, considering the Monochlamydiae, it is in case of dicots, polypetali, gamma petali, and Monochlamydiae. So, Monochlamydiae is considered to be very artificial one. So, that cannot be a merit of this system. Placing of Monochlamydiae after gamma petali does not seem to be natural. What they did? That first they consider the polypetali, which is the primitive one. So they consider the gamma petali, which is the advanced. And again they consider that the Monochlamydiae placing after gamma petali, that is also do not shows the primitive characters, natural system. So again, this is one of the demerit of the Bentham Hanukkah system of classification. Some of the closely related species are placed distinctly. Means some of the species shows very, very close relation in their morphological characters, but they have been placed distinctly, while distant species are placed close to each other. Thus, this is also one of the demerit of Bentham Hanukkah system. Certain families of Monochlamydiae are closely related to families in Polypetali. Example is Chenopodiaceae and Caryophyllaceae. Both families having characters which are similar to Polypetali. Then why they have kept in Monochlamydiae? Chenopodiaceae also show the characters of over superior ovary, then petals being free. So these are the demerits that they kept Chenopodiaceae and Caryophyllaceae in Monochlamydiae. So this is the demerit. Let's see what are the other demerits of the Bentham Hanukkah system. Advanced families such as Orchidaceae has been considered primitive in this system by placing them in the beginning. So this is also demerit, because Orchidaceae is now considered as one of the most advanced family in seed bearing plant. Of course, it is a monocot family, but in case of Bentham Hanukkah system, they consider it in first, that is the primitive one. Placing of Orchidaceae in the beginning of monocot is unnatural, as it is one of the most advanced families of monocots. Similarly, Compositae, or it is also called as the Asteraceae, has been placed near the beginning of the gamma petali, which is quite unnatural. Now, Compositae, very peculiar characteristics that they are, of course, they have a thalamic florus character, but their flowers are highly advanced. The arrangement of flowers is also very, means the ray florets on around and this florets in the center. So there are different characters which are to be considered to be advanced, but they kept it very beginning of the gamma petali. So this is also unnatural. Liliaceae and Amaryllidaceae were kept apart merely on the basis of characters of ovary, though they are very closely related. Now, in case of the Liliaceae and Amaryllidaceae, most of the characters of leaf, root, stem, flowers, most of the characters are very, very close. But considering the only character of ovary, they kept it far away from each other. So this is also a demerit of this system. there were no phylogenetic consideration. Now this system of classification has not considered the phylogenetic characters. That is the demerit of Bentham Huduka system of classification. With this we finish the complete classification of the Bentham Huduka system of classification. So I request all students to learn it, go through the slides, study it well, and we will start with the study of various angiospermic families. Total 7 families are there, 2 monocots and 5 dicot families are there. In the next lecture, we will study, go through the 2 families. So I request all students to study it well. If you have any questions or queries, please SMS or WhatsApp me. So thanks a lot for listening to this video. Thank you.